They're moving on. Yeah, they're giving up. Now. Don't lose your nerves. You're videoing, sure.
Everybody
yeah.
Survived.
Well, survived. Yeah, that's the old bloody not believe it.
Look at this one. Can you even believe that this one can actually stand on a face like that? Because most of the dogs have lost interest here. The wild dogs.
Yeah.
Potentially. But then we saw them looking in the forest and looking like everywhere. The baby's probably in the best position because the wild dogs can't actually leverage themselves on anything to get that low. But it's just a shear. This male, that the wild dogs are pretty close to him. If he had kind of flint, he might have put himself in a more precarious position. No, unfortunately they just outnumbered here, so if you watch them, you have nice perspective because you're that sighting of an area where that young thing is bouncing around the rock. So you see that they're very agile on it, but I don't think their agility will be a match for a pack of wild dogs at this stage, should they choose to feed.
Right. And you don't have enough rocks,
yeah, I mean with this tree here, I don't know what it looks like behind them, but I know that there are a number of wild dogs that are.
Yeah, I'd rather go find something. Where did the other half of the pack go?
first and I went up in that direction.
Would they split like that?
Yeah. Yeah, they would. And then they do like a long to try and contact call to one another, so everyone in the pack will do that in different areas, and that's how they locate one another.
You can cover it like a hole. You just spot the land.
Yeah.
You can find two or three kills and then go back to them.
Yeah.
If they can catch that wildebeest, it can be nice, eh? Oh, that wildebeest, they've seen them. They're all lying flat, but he's seen them now.